Okay, the word inspirational is an understatement when you talk about Blake Leeper. He is one of the fastest runners on the planet, and he does it on prosthetic legs. Blake Leeper is here this morning joining us in the KCAL 9 studio. Welcome. Thank you so much for coming. Now, you have big goals ahead of you. You are trying to be the first Paralympic track and field star for the Olympics coming up next year.
Yes, you know, being born with a congenital birth defect, I'm trying to claim that title as the first double-leg American to compete in the Olympic Games and the Paralympic Games as well. I think it'd be a great opportunity to shed light, not only to me, but to the Paralympics and all the 54 million disabled in America, and there's so many around the world, that just show the world that regardless of your disability, if you have the right mindset and you can dig deep, you can overcome any challenge that's thrown your way. I'm a real true believer of that.
Yeah, and I can tell with your clinging and clinging, these are all your medals. These are from all the games. Let's talk about some of the medals that you're wearing, and all of this has qualified you to compete.
Yeah. So in 2012, I took a silver and a bronze in the 200, a silver in the 400, and you know, it was just amazing, and I was so honored and so blessed to take any medals at home, but I'm missing one.
The gold
medal. So I had to come back, and I took three silvers, and I actually took a gold medal as well. It's sitting right there. We broke the world record. So me and three other amazing guys on the U.S. Paralympic team, Jerome Singleton and Richard Brown, Gerald Wallace, we stuck together and we broke the world record by a whole second.
Oh, so. My goodness. Let's talk about how fast you can actually run on your blade.
Yeah.
You run fast. Was it, I was reading, is it something about the 4x100?
Yeah. So the 4x100, we went 40.7. My 200 meter time is 21.7. And my 100 meter time is 10.91. And I was the second double leg amputee ever to go under 11 seconds in 100 meters. And it's truly amazing just to think. You have to understand, the day that I was born, the doctor said I would never walk. Now I'm running at 21, 22, 23 miles per hour.
Faster than most people.
And so I just let people know that everything I've been through in my life, all my trials and tribulations, every time I wanted to give up, it was just prepare me for the future and prepare me for my next mission.
So. I love that. And also your story is so inspirational that the California Lottery they've documented you in their new series called Project Believe. You're one of six people in California that they've done the story about.
Yeah, it's awesome. You know, it's just really about believing in yourself. Project Believes, CABelieves.com. And it's just taking something, believing in something bigger than yourself, and going out and inspiring somebody else. It is pretty amazing that I'm one of the six that's been chosen. They got me feeling like a celebrity now. You know, I'm shooting and we're doing all this crazy stuff. So I guess next up is a movie deal now.
Oh.
We'll have to see.
I can probably see that coming. Last week you actually played with a bunch of other celebrities at the NBA All-Star.
Yeah.
Was that a dream come
true? Oh my
through?
Goodness. You have to understand, Madison Square Garden, playing with Kevin Hart, Common, Sarah Silverman, so many great individuals, and it's pretty cool. Here I am, the kid with no legs, you know, standing, being the first double-leg amputee ever to play in the NBA. You know, hopefully with my message, with my story, it just opens up so many doors for the future. And I might be the first, but hopefully I won't be the last.
Oh, I hope so. And, you know, we know you as a track and field star, but you do like basketball.
Yeah, I do like basketball. I consider basketball my first love. You know,
really?
Playing basketball, it was a way for me at a young age to show the community, don't treat me any different. If you're gonna respect me on the basketball court, if you're gonna guard me to the last second shot in the fourth quarter, respect me in the classroom. Respect me when you see me walking in the community. Respect me regardless if I am missing my legs.
Right.
It just so happens I am a little bit faster and better at track and field, so I am gonna go with that calling in my destiny. But it was just cool to say I could take it back and play in Madison Square Garden and play my favorite game, which is basketball.
And then really quick, do you change out your prosthetics if you're playing basketball?
Yes.
This is not what you would
be
on the court.
So this is just when I didn't want to beat somebody in a foot race, right? And so when I'm playing basketball, I do have my walking pair that I can switch out my shoes and different pair. And that's the good thing about prosthetics and it being 2015 is that regardless of your situation, there's so many things you can do. There's a biking leg, there's a swimming leg.
Oh my God.
For women, there's heels, you know, that I've never tried them personally. but they say that they're amazing. And that's really the main message is no excuses. Everybody kind of gets caught up in the physical disability and what they don't have. But at the end of the day, I'm a true believer that the only disability in life is a bad attitude.
Thank you so much, Blake. I wish I could talk to you all day long. This is a name to look out for. You're going to start to compete in August.
Yes.
So for more information about Blake, just head to our website, kcal9.com, click Scene on TV.